Why? Hello and welcome everybody. It is Pox again. So today we're not going to go ahead and do a progress update video with the character. I'll be doing that one later. I also just realized this kind of looks like a... Oh, never mind. I was going to say that looked like a little charm that was on top of his face. Reminded me of anime. Anyway, though, I wanted to make this video because a lot of people are asking me about like Endgame and Grim Dawn, or they're comparing Grim Dawn to Path of Exile, which is the more popular one. And I want to really give you guys an explanation of what Grim Dawn is going to offer you. Now, this isn't specifically going to talk about Endgame. I'm not at Endgame, and there's more to do in things in life than just Endgame. So let me give you the basic rundown of if Grim Dawn is for you or not. So, step one. Grim Dawn offers a multi-class system. It's completely different than Path of Exile. Path of Exile offers a gigantic skill tree that you allocate points on that don't have active skills, but they have, you know, keystones. Grim Dawn literally has active skills, passive skills within your two classes. Now, when you have your two classes, you can respec as much as you'd like. You can respec everything in here. You just can't respec the class once you have put a single point into it. Okay? So you can literally respec everything as much as you'd like. It's super simple. You just go back to town, talk to the person. It only costs money. On top of having a multi-class system, pretty much every single category, like class, synergizes together. There may be like some really weird ones, but I promise you, if you put the time in and the effort in, there are crazy combinations that will work. And the reason why they work is the following. There are legendary items, unique items, whatever you'd like to call them in Grim Dawn. Legendary items slash unique items. There's also set items, but the game is not built around set items like Diablo 3. Every single one of these unique items will come with a granted skill slash proc effect, meaning you will have skill, skill, proc, proc, skill, proc, proc, skill, proc. And then say you have some crafted gear so it doesn't have procs on it, right? Some of the items in Grim Dawn are completely build enabling, just like they are in Path of Exile. In Path of Exile, you have items like Threshold Jewels, and Threshold Jewels will modify the way a skill is played. In Grim Dawn, you can have specific skills attached to weapons, and those I think are called MIs, Monster Infrequence. So basically, you could have one that says, let's see, Force Wave. Force Wave now has reduced cooldown and damage is converted to fire. So all of a sudden, and I don't know if that's actually in the game, but you know, it could be something like that, complete 100% converted to fire. Now you can pair your soldier with a completely new class building around a pure fire Force Wave. So just that one piece of gear that you lock yourself to opens an entire class and new unique gearing just for that, on top of the Devotion Tree system. The Devotion Tree system is probably the best system I've ever seen in any game of my life. Call me a fanboy, say I'm dick sucking, I don't care, let me explain it to you. What the Devotion Tree does is the Devotion Tree is basically like your third class. Your Devotion Tree can be defensive, your Devotion Tree can be offensive. Your Devotion Tree can give you movement speed. Your Devotion Tree can give you all the proc chances you want. It can give you offensive proc, defensive proc, armor shred, debuff shred, or elemental shred, sustain. It can give you second wind. It can give you everything. So let's break it down really simply. There's five categories of your devotions. If you just hover over, you can see the constellations highlighting based off of what type they are. Now the Devotion Tree can be respec'd as much as you'd like as well. It just costs Aether Shards, which are a bit, they're not even that tedious to grind once you learn how to get them. Anyway though, so on the Devotion Tree, what I recommend for players to do is find 1 to 2 constellations that are big boy ones, and you want to build around them. So what does that mean? Well, let's take a look at Ulrion. So you can have a total of 55 devotion points. Ulrion is a big one. Why is it a big one? Because it costs 20 purple. 20 purple means you are invested quite a bit into purple, right? So Ulrion, if we look at it, would give like pretty big stat scaling, right? Considering if you level up, you get like 10 of a stat. This gives you 30, 30, and 100. If you keep looking, 80% fizz damage. In any game you play, 80% should be a big number, right? Let's take a look more. I know this may not seem like it's a lot, but it's a really good node. Let's keep moving on. You get a proc chance. Blind Fury. So this is level 1. This will level up with you as you scale. Whenever you see a red thing here, there's two ways you can support it. This says chance on crit. Chance on crit means it's probably going to go on like one of your main skills, but it means more importantly, it's going to be supported by an attack. So say you have, you know, a really good skill, your main skill that you use. You click it, you can see what you can select it with, you select it on top of it. Now you have your regular skill. Let's say we had Force Wave, that is pure fire conversion, and on top of it having pure fire conversion from the unique we had, it's being supported with the skill tree with something else, right? So you can turn a single target skill into an AoE skill, you can turn a debuffing skill into a crazy debuff skill, you can even do it, whereas I have, for example, you can make it so your mobility skills give you buffs. So if you look here, I have Ul'zod, the Herald of Korvok. What Ul'zod does is I have Vanish on this. Vanish is basically my mobility skill. When I use Vanish, there's a 68% chance that when I hit the target, I gain the following buffs. They're pretty nice buffs. This makes for a more hit and run style. So I can disengage and then re-engage, get a buff. When the buff falls off, I can disengage and re-engage, assuming it's a really, you know, difficult target. One thing about the Devotion Tree that a lot of new players just don't realize, because I don't think it's explained anywhere, is again one of the best systems ever. So if you look, Ul'zod's Decree has a 20% chance on attacked proc. Well, 20% kind of sucks, right? If you have a skill with a 5-second cooldown, you tell yourself that's going to take ages to proc, right? I want something that has good consistency, good uptime. Well, if a skill has a cooldown on it, the cooldown actually buffs up the percentage to put them in line. So this goes from 20%. Vanquish has a 3.6 second cooldown up to a 68% chance to proc, meaning half the time I use my mobility skill, which I use all the time because it's my mobility skill, I get my buff. And sure, it doesn't have 100% uptime, but you see what I mean of the consistency? So now you can grab another one, right? Because I've got more mobility skills. And the game just has such beautiful progression with that. And then later on the line, say you don't like it anymore, you can remove it, respec your entire thing to something different, right? Say you end up getting insane damage from all of your gear, you can respec your devotion tree to be completely defensive. And that is the beauty of the devotion system, where you just have so much depth of customization. One other thing to like kind of help you guys out with how this works is, say I want to get Wretch, right? Wretch is a 1 affinity unlock. So I can't get it yet, I need to put an affinity in pink, right? So I put something in pink. By unlocking Wretch, it actually gives you the constellation completion for 2 pink and 3 blue, which means I could now remove this point and I have this by itself. So that's where a lot of, you know, big brain thinking comes in, where you can actually really min-max your devotion tree to get some crazy stuff out of it. But again, it all depends on your build. Say you prioritize and get like the most insane equipment in the world, but you're gated by one thing only, sustain and life leech. So you tell yourself, how do I get sustain and life leech? Look to the devotion tree. You know why? Because my buddy named Mr. Ghoul, where is Ghoul on here? Right here, Ghoul gives you, for example, where is it here? 4% of attack damage converted to health and a proc chance that gives you leech. It's all over there, man. They spent a lot of time and a lot of work on here. You've got things like bubbles at low HP. You've got things that give you crazy sustain. You've got like crazy regeneration steroids. So much stuff in here. So I urge you guys to really spend some time and work with it, because in Grim Dawn, the combat may not be the most satisfying for you. I personally find it to be pretty nice. The engine may not be the smoothest, like a Diablo 3 budget. It's pretty good though, you know? The speed may not be as fast as Path of Exile when you've got ridiculous things going. But it has the content, and it has the theory crafting potential to you know, spend hundreds of hours upon multiple characters creating your dream characters. Do you want to play a crit summoner? Because you can. There's a crit summoner. It's a thing, and it's really fucking strong. It was my last character that I played. So anyway, that's pretty much the main thing I wanted to talk about. I wanted you guys to know that, you know, a lot of people look at Grim Dawn in a really narrow way, and they just start the game and they go, it's very slow. And that's okay, it's okay. But you need to understand all of the other things in the game to do. I haven't even spoken about components, augments. We haven't talked about any of that stuff yet. We're just talking about the basics of the game, right? Rep farming, crafting your gear, farming for those monster implicits we were talking about, doing like reputation farming on top of the nemesis boss hunting, crucible farming for endgame gear. There's so much content to be unlocked. You gotta ease yourself into it one step at a time and really enjoy it. And I know chat really wants me to say this one too. The game has mod support. I personally try to stay away from add-ons in most games I play. It's a personal choice, but it's there too. So a lot of things that may feel clunky to you, some basic, you know, just some basic things, you can most likely fix with the add-on support since the game has been out for a couple of years. And I think the game still might be on a crazy sale on Humble Bundle if you want to check it out. Anyway though, I just wanted to give you guys some updates as to, you know, how I personally really feel about Grim Dawn. There's just so much content, like I said, and I just really wanted to make sure you guys are getting on the right foot when you're getting some information about the game. Because I know a lot of people just, they tune in on the stream, they click, they see streamer doing the same thing in every game, they kill mobs instantly, but the game looks slower than X games, so why would I play it? But anyway, you know, like I said, hope you guys had a wonderful time. Hope you guys enjoyed yourselves. If you liked the video, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe. And remember, you can catch me streaming live every day at twitch.tv/pox. Take care. Have a wonderful time, everybody.